Hello students, welcome to online lectures of Mumbai International School and Junior College. This lecture is for class 4, subject EBS 2, lesson Shivaji gives the slip to the emperor. Let's begin. Shivaji gives the slip to the emperor. Let us have a quick recap. Children, Shivaji had a lot of fights with the Mughals, and at last, to save his men and land, in order to stop the fights, Shivaji signed a treaty, a contract of peace with the emperor. With this treaty, there will be no more fights and wars. Shivaji signed the treaty of peace before Mirza Rajay Jai Singh. Mirza Rajay Jai Singh was Aurangzeb's great general who convinced Shivaji to sign the treaty of peace. Mirza Rajay Jai Singh also suggested Shivaji to go Agra and meet Aurangzeb. Shivaji knew that it was not safe to meet Aurangzeb as he could not be trusted. Still, Shivaji told Jai Singh that he wanted to go to Agra to meet the emperor Aurangzeb. Now, in this lesson we will learn what happened when Shivaji reached Agra and how did he give a slip to the Mughal emperor. How did he escape from Agra? Trusting the Mughal general Jai Singh, Shivaji left for Agra to meet Aurangzeb. Before leaving for Agra, Shivaji handed over the administration and control of his Swaraj to his mother Jijabai. Shivaji took blessings of his mother Jijabai and left for Agra. Shivaji took with him his son Sambhaji Raje, some sardars, and also carried with him a large treasure, meaning lot of money, jewelry, etc. And in due course, meaning in right time, Shivaji reached Agra. Shivaji shows his spirit at the emperor's court. Children, here we will see what happens in the emperor's court. It was Aurangzeb's 50th birthday. Shivaji Maharaj went to the emperor's darbar and Shivaji's son Sambhaji also went with him. After finishing the court in Diwane Khas, the emperor entered the hall where the matters and cases of the state were discussed. Children, Diwane Khas is a special place in the fort where the Mughal emperor welcomes his special guest and also meets the people of his court. So, after finishing the court in Diwane Khas, the emperor entered the hall where the matters of the state were discussed. In the hall, all the sardars were given a place according to their position and status. The sardars of high position and status were given a place in the front row. As Shivaji was the king of Maharashtra, he should have been given a place in the front rows. But people like Jaswant Singh Rathod, whom Shivaji and his Marathas have defeated many times, was given a position ahead of Shivaji. Jaswant Singh Rathod, whose position and status was far less than Shivaji, was given the honor and respect of standing in the front row before Shivaji. The emperor willingly and intentionally put Shivaji in one of the back rows. This made Shivaji angry. After all, Shivaji was the king of sovereign state, self-governed state Maharashtra. Of course, his position and his status demanded that he should get a position in the front row. The Mughal emperor knowingly gave Shivaji a position in the back row in order to insult him. But Shivaji was not ready to take this. He felt angry and insulted. Angry and insulted, Shivaji left the hall. He went back to his house in Agra. He decided that he will never see the emperor's face again. He decided that he will never meet the emperor again. Hence, Shivaji's visit to Agra did not go well. It was a failure. And the news of what happened with Shivaji at Aurangzeb's court in Agra spread everywhere. The emperor's treachery. Children, treachery means things that are done to fool people or to betray people, to break their trust or to trap them. Here, Emperor Aurangzeb has also done something like this with Shivaji. Let us see what treachery did Aurangzeb do. When Shivaji and his son Sambhaji returned home, Aurangzeb ordered his guards to be posted around Shivaji's residence, his home. In short, Shivaji and his son Sambhaji were captured, or you could say, Shivaji and Sambhaji were arrested in their own house. Shivaji and Sambhaji were not allowed to leave their house. Shivaji and Sambhaji thus became Aurangzeb's prisoners, Kaidi. Shivaji understood Aurangzeb's treachery. Shivaji understood that Aurangzeb would never allow him to go back to Maharashtra. Many days and weeks passed. Then one day Shivaji petitioned to the emperor, that is, appealed and requested the permission to return to Maharashtra. But his request was rejected. He tried again and again, but every time his request was rejected. Then Shivaji Maharaj made up his mind. He decided that come what may, whatever happens, he will escape, he will run away, he will break free from the prison of Aurangzeb. Firstly, Shivaji got the permission to send back the persons who had come with him to Agra. Aurangzeb felt that if he gives permission for the return of Shivaji's men, then he would be alone and weak. So Aurangzeb gave the permission to send Shivaji's men back to Maharashtra. Aurangzeb was happy. He thought that now Shivaji would be completely alone. Now, only three people were left with Shivaji in Agra. His son Sambhaji Raje and the two servants, his workers and helpers, Hiroji Farjan and Madari Mehtar. After Shivaji's men safely left for Maharashtra, Shivaji pretended to be ill. Shivaji was fit and fine, but he just showed that he was not feeling well and he was ill. Shivaji Maharaj complained of severe stomach ache, too bad, acute stomach pain. So doctors were called and they started Shivaji's treatment. In this time, Shivaji came up with a plan to escape. Shivaji started sending out huge baskets of sweets to sadhus and maulvis to get their blessings so that he could get well soon, so that he could recover soon. Escape from Agra. Now let us see how Shivaji escaped from Agra, how Shivaji ran away from Agra and reached his home safely in Maharashtra. In the beginning, when Shivaji Maharaj sent huge baskets of sweets outside the palace, the guards outside the palace would examine, check the baskets. But then they got bored doing the same thing every day. And then they stopped checking the baskets of sweets. Shivaji Maharaj took advantage of this situation. One evening, Shivaji made Hiroji, his servant, to sleep in his bed and asked Madari, his other servant, to massage his feet. Shivaji did this because he wanted everyone to believe that he is sleeping in his bed and he is still there in the palace. Then Shivaji Maharaj and Sambhaji sat in the baskets of sweets and hid themselves in two of the baskets of sweets which were going out. The baskets were supposed to have sweets, so the guards did not check the baskets that were going out of the palace. In this way, Shivaji Maharaj and his son Sambhaji Raje easily got out of the palace without any trouble. Then at a pre-decided place, a place which was already decided earlier, Shivaji and Sambhaji Raje got out of the baskets. Shivaji's faithful servants were waiting for them with horses so that they could run far away. Then at that time only, Shivaji's servants, Hiroji and Madari, left the house in Agra by saying that they were going to the doctor to get some medicines for Shivaji. Hiroji and Madari also played an important role in freeing Shivaji. They put their lives in danger to free Shivaji from his prison in Agra. The Mughal Emperor Aurangzeb came to know of Shivaji's escape the next day. The next day Aurangzeb came to know that Shivaji ran away. This made him mad with anger. He became very angry. His sardars were also frightened of him, afraid of him. Aurangzeb sent spies, jasus all over the country to find Shivaji, but all his search was a waste, a failure. Once escaped, once ran away, the Maratha lion Shivaji was never going to be caught in the emperor's net again. Once escaped, Shivaji would never get in the hands of the emperor. In disguise, Shivaji Maharaj started towards Maharashtra, meaning Shivaji changed the way he looked, his appearance, his identity, his name, his dress, etc., and started traveling towards Maharashtra. Shivaji Maharaj left young Sambhaji Raje in a safe place in Mathura, and in due course, in correct time, he reached Rajgarh. Jija Mata was more than happy to see Shivaji safe and back home. 2 months later, after 2 months, Sambhaji Raje also came to Rajgarh safely. In this way, with great skill, great technique, better understanding about situation and daring, Shivaji gave the slip to the emperor. Shivaji escaped from Agra and returned to the safety of his kingdom. All this happened in 1666. This was all about the lesson Shivaji gives the slip to the emperor.